Saturday, I got on the car, this is the first time I got to home, because I loved it, man. Because it was a real thing that was happening. And I think that's been my trouble all the time. I ain't had time to get out and talk to people, or be with many people.
He told me one time, I know, but put a lot of stuff in his head that his family didn't like.
Woo! You sexy motherfucker, you!
Turn around.
We will be getting along just fine, and they will bring a real pretty girl around them. And she would say, you don't have to stay here with her. She's too old. You should have a family.
He loves that woman. For some reason, I don't know why, but he does.
So I never, my wife had intention of having him. The way I had to come up when I was a kid, it took the czar out of my heart to have a little baby and know the shape the world was in too.
My husband didn't like for him to marry her because she's much older than he was. And he knew it wasn't going to work out. But for a while he did. And in no time, just everything went haywire with him. We were just arguing and quarreling and threatening to kill each other with guns.
Thank you.
said, "Are you Miss Wade?" I said, "Yeah." She said, "I tell you, I have missed your husband worse than anything in the world." She said, "There was the honest man and I ever met in my life." Said, "He'd come through the store skipping and hitting her leg two in the floor." She said, "I look for that every month." And I said, "He was an honest and good man. And you can go anywhere in this town and ask about that man. He was a good man." I remember when I lived in Carlisle, he would get up before daylight and get a drink.
Oh,